I'd also like to talk about disclosure. Now, there's always questions about what's material fact, what's not material fact, and most people have heard me talk about this over the years since we got material fact into our legislation, which was, you know, a major change, you know, probably 12, 13 years ago now. And really the question is to disclose or not to disclose. So, you know, that is the question, if we want to ponder it in that way. So let's have a think about to disclose or not to disclose. The question that was asked of us this week was about deceased estates. Now, does that fit into the material fact definition? Well, no, it doesn't. Unless, of course, the person died in the premises from, you know, the result of a violent crime. So now the case that was brought to our discussion by a student was someone who had passed away in the property. The agent had passed away, but not in the property, of natural causes. And the agent used the marketing tool of saying that it was a deceased estate. The vendor became agitated and upset about it being advertised in that manner, because he felt that it was driving purchasers away. And apparently one purchaser walked away and used the excuse, so we're not saying it's absolute definite, but used the excuse that it was, oh, I don't want to live in a property because it was a deceased estate. Well, they came and looked at it in the first place. So I'd say they were, you know, pulling that as an excuse as opposed to a reality. But because there's no legislative requirement around disclosing or not disclosing the deceased estate, unless, of course, the person's died in the property or from something that happened in the property as the result of a violent crime. But it comes down to, you need to start the conversation with your vendor. So if the vendor, if it's a deceased estate, the contract, the front page of the contract will probably say the estate of the late, and it'll have that written there. So, you know, often it's very, very clear to any purchaser anyway that it's a deceased estate. But around that, it's a discussion in terms of the customer journey that you are trying to enhance with your vendor. Then start the conversation. Say, this is how we're planning on advertising it. Here is yet another reason why you should show your advertising to your vendor before it goes to print, before you put it up on your website, and say, this is what we're doing. This is why we're doing it. These are our strategies around why we're doing it. And this is what we believe the outcomes will be. Have the conversation. So it's a really simple one. This is more about good practice and, you know, enhancing the customer journey as opposed to what is legislatively required when it comes around to disclosing or not disclosing about certain things about a property. And deceased estates is one of those. So that's, whilst it's still very grey around that area, it really is quite clear that from a practical point of view, I'll say it again, start the conversation.